Hey everybody, and welcome to the Hot Tag with your girl Izzy. Today I am so excited to welcome you to my interview with a future NXT Women's Champion. She is a participant in the first ever Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic and the newest NXT signee. She is Cora Jade. What's up?
Hello, thank you so much for having me.
Of course. Thank you so much for coming on the show. I know you've been crazy busy, and this has been quite the big week for you with everything happening and you being signed to NXT and being announced as a participant for the Women's Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic. Overall, how are you doing?
It's definitely a lot. Obviously, in the best way possible. I wanted this since I was like 8 years old. I just turned 20 a few days ago. So it's been a long
Happy birthday.
Thank you. It's been a long, long time coming for this, but I'm super excited. Obviously everything's still very new, still kind of getting into the flow of things, getting ready for the big move and all that, but it's been the time of my life so far. So I'm so excited to see where it goes from here.
Yeah, definitely. And we will be getting into NXT shortly. And you were just talking about how you were 8 years old and starting to get into pro wrestling. So was there like a specific match that just made you say, I want to do this one day?
I don't know if there was a specific match. My dad and my younger brother, he's 3 years younger than me. When I was eight, my dad had gotten my brother into it. And so it was kind of like their thing. And then I obviously saw it. And at first I was like, I don't care about this. But then like, my brother quickly fell out of it and like was completely uninterested. Okay. But then I was the one who was like, oh my God, this is so cool. So like my brother didn't care anymore. And then I like was obsessed with it. And then I remember just watching it one day. I think it was some Michelle McCool match or something like mm-hmm. that on SmackDown, I believe. Couldn't tell you when or what it was. That's kind of all I remember. And I remember my dad being like, you know, you could do that one day. And like,
oh, okay.
Click in my head that like these are like real people who like do this. It just, I don't know, I'm like young and dumb, so I didn't know, but I was like, oh my God, like ever since that moment I was like, I need to do this. So my head was like,
that's
set
awesome
there. Yes.
Yeah, and I think all pro wrestling fans kind of have that match that just makes them fall in love with the sport. And that's just really just cool to hear how it was kind of like a family thing, except when your brother kind of like was like,
yeah.
I don't like this anymore. But yeah. Since we were just talking about the beginning of your journey, I think it's now time to get into NXT. And I'm just so excited to talk about this. And I got to ask you this question because I'm just dying to know. What is that feeling like when you get the call that you are officially part of the NXT women's roster?
Honestly, it's even still now, it's kind of like it hasn't like sunk in yet. So like, obviously I'm very excited and happy, but it's still like I'm waiting for that moment to like, it kind of hit like a few days ago when they announced it on Twitter, but still I'm kind of like getting into the whole like, oh, this is like actually happening and I'm not having a dream. But yeah, I was like, I started doing like my whole month of October, I was just like all as much as I can, you know, the pandemic makes things a little bit crazier. It's hard to like, mm-hmm. you obviously want to be safe and take the precautions and everything yes. like that. But my October kind of like blew up and I think I was home for maybe like 2 or 3 days, like in the month of October. And I was working so many indie shows and all that kind of thing. And then I got the call kind of last minute. And then I had my tryout at the end of October. So obviously that was like, oh my God, like I didn't expect this. I had my tryout at the end of October. And then finding out that I was going to be in the first ever Women's Dusty Classic was obviously a shocker. I didn't expect that to come right away, but obviously the faster you get into it, the better. I'm so excited. And it's just a very surreal thing to be a part of. So I'm excited.
Yeah, I'm sure. And it's just like a special feeling that you really can't describe. When you got to the Capitol Wrestling Center, did it sink in a little bit or like?
It definitely did. And I feel like I was like a kid in a candy store because it's like everywhere I look is like all these like people I like grew up watching because I'm still like fairly young. Like I mm-hmm. started watching it when I was eight, but to like be around these people and it's like, these are my like co-workers and my peers now, it's like I looked up to like so many of these people for so long mm-hmm. and like I still look at them as like, oh my God, like you're like my hero and like all that sort of thing. So it's cool to like mix those two together and like have like that because I'm still a fan and mm-hmm. I hope that never goes away. So it's like to have those like the professional and like fan aspect to like mix together is a really cool thing because it's like it's what I always wanted.
Mm-hmm, definitely. And, you know, throughout 2020 and, you know, at the beginning of 2021, you definitely created a buzz on social media, including in the independent scene. And I think you have a huge advantage going into NXT since you've been a part of numerous promotions and worked your way up in the independent scene. So how has that experience prepared you for this next chapter in your career?
Honestly, I had so much fun at my time on the indies. I met some of my best friends in the whole world. I've like worked so many good people in all these places. And I was only on there for, I think it was less on the indie scene for less than 2 years. So my time was fairly short, but, I had like the time of my life and, it was just everything I did and all the people I met definitely prepared me. I learned so much from so many people. Like Kylie Rae was one of my biggest, one of my closest friends and biggest like mentors throughout my independent time. So she helped me so much, including so many other people. So I don't think I would have gotten here if it wasn't for everyone that I met and worked with along the way. So I'm so grateful for that.
Yeah, that's awesome. And like I said, you created such a big buzz on like social media. Like every time I'd scroll on Twitter, I just see, you know, Cora Jade. And it was just really awesome and interesting to see you create like this like whole buzz basically. So, and I also think like a lot of this experience is going to come in handy tonight as you make your debut match on 205 Live and compete in the first ever Women's Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic alongside Gigi Dolin. And you two are going up against Candice LeRae and Indy Hartwell. So with that being said, do you feel like there's an overwhelming amount of pressure on you two to get the victory or make a huge impression and put the women's division on notice?
There definitely is, because like you said, it is the first ever Women's Dusty Classic, and it is also, we are the first women to ever appear on 205 Live, which is also just adds another aspect of, you know, the pressure, but it's good pressure. Indy and Candice are people I respect and have seen like flourish in this business, so I'm super excited to face them. Obviously, I'm going to get that win, but it's going to be a challenge, but a good challenge, and Gigi and I have known each other a little bit on the independent scene, so that helps create that bond and that little bit of familiarity going into this, so super excited, and it should be a good one.
Yeah, definitely. And I'm just so excited to see this match. And I know the whole WWE universe is too. And for everybody watching, make sure you tune in tonight at 10 p.m. Eastern time, right after SmackDown. And Cora, I want to ask you, where can everybody find you on social media?
All right, so I just changed all my little new social media. So if you were following my old ones, I have currently changed my Instagram and Twitter to at CoraJWWE. And that's about it.
It's simple, but I like it. You got to keep it simple. And I just wanted to say thank you so much for joining me today. I know you've been super busy and this has been like such a crazy week for you, but I really appreciate you coming on the show and I really can't wait for all the big things you're going to do in NXT.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for having me. I always see your little videos like this all the time and it seems like always such a good time. So I'm glad to be here.
Thank you. That's what we're all about on The Hot Tag. And thank you guys for tuning in to this episode of The Hot Tag with your girl Izzy and Cora Jade. I will see you guys next time. Bye.